being in the social media world for the last 12 years, I guess, I just feel like there's such a pressure put on people that if you want to be happy and to be successful in life, you've got to have money, you've got to have an incredible job, and you've got to have once-in-a-lifetime experiences, and you've got to have all these relationships, and you have to accomplish all these things. And there's 12 guys who have spent the last, five guys who have spent the last 12 years checking all of those boxes beyond our wildest imagination. I can promise you that none of those things in any amount compared to the joy of knowing Jesus Christ as our personal Lord and Savior. Money you have, you're not defined by the things that you accomplish in life, and most importantly, you're not identified by your flaws and your mistakes, and that's really important for a guy like me who's a very flawed individual. And I know we're called do perfect, but we are the furthest thing from that, and we all have our own issues just like everybody else, and the only thing perfect about us is the perfect sacrifice that Jesus made on the cross, paving the way for us to spend eternity in heaven. The best example of God's love for us that I've experienced on this earth is when I became a dad 4.5 years ago. My wife and I struggled to get pregnant. We had a couple miscarriages, and we didn't know if we would ever have children of our own. And I remember the weeks leading up to our oldest parent's birth. I started to accept that this was going to happen, that this was going to be a reality. I was going to have a little boy. It was going to be mine. And I just remember I started to have all these hopes and dreams and things that I wanted them to do and look like. And I wanted them to like hunting and fishing with me. I wanted them to be good at sports. And I wanted them to secretly kind of be 6 foot tall because my dad's 5'7" and I'm 5'9". And if I could give them 2 inches, maybe steal an inch from a basketball program somewhere in high school, we got ourselves a 6-footer. I think he's going to be a 5'10 guy. I think he's going to be just, you know, pretty average. But the moment that he was born in that delivery room, all of those hopes and dreams vanished. And the only thing that mattered in that moment was that that was my little boy and that I loved him. And there was nothing that he could do to change that. It didn't matter what he looked like. It didn't matter what he accomplished. It didn't matter what he had done, what he will do. And he didn't have to do anything to earn that love. It was given to him. And that will never change. It's an unconditional love of the dad. And probably many of you in here can relate to. And I think the best Bible story that portrays that love is probably the story of the prodigal son. It's my favorite story in the Bible. And the short version of that is a young man goes to his dad and basically says, I don't want to live under your roof anymore. I want to get out of this house. I want my inheritance now. I want everything that's owed to me when you pass away, and I want to get out of here. And his father granted him that wish, and he gave him everything that he was going to get. And he went off, and the Bible says he squandered everything that he had on a reckless living. And he got to the point where he had nothing left. He had no one to turn to, and he thought that all those things that were going to make him happy in life, money and experiences and everything that the world had to offer that he thought that he put such high importance to, they all went down. And he basically got to a point where he had to go back to his dad's house and hope that he would hire him on as a servant. He thought that was his only option. He didn't know how he would handle it or what he would do. And the Bible says that the young man started the journey back to his dad's house, and his dad saw him coming while he was still a long ways off. And his dad saw that his little boy, and he felt compassion for him, and he took off running after his little boy with his arms wide open, ready to embrace him and ready to accept him, not because of what he had done, but because it was the free gift of a father's love. And that's the exact same way that God loves us, and that's such a beautiful truth. When you accept that and realize that grace and mercy that's given to us freely, it's a decision that the Bible hasn't made, and you believe what the Bible says in Romans, and if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, that you'll be saved. We also believe what the Bible says in Ephesians, it's by grace that we've been saved through faith, and it's not by works, and there is nothing that you can do to earn your way into heaven. Thank goodness. You can't lose that salvation once it's something that you've accepted. It is a free gift, just like the free gift that I give my sons. Praise God for all three of them. And such a beautiful gift. And thank you guys. I don't know why you get emotional when you become a dad, but I think your tear ducts will start producing more, I guess. So, sorry about that. But man, if you guys could be here with one thing tonight, it wouldn't be the latest and greatest Duke Perfect March, or that you go home and binge watch all the Duke Perfect videos. But you would just leave here knowing that you're radically and recklessly loved by the creator of the universe. He wants a personal relationship with you. So thank you guys for letting me talk to you.